The steel bridge is the only one like it in the world that can do all these things, accommodate all these modes. It's like this sort of steampunk with muscles and gears and counterweights. It can move all sorts of different dimensions. There's nothing like it really in the world. The first steel bridge was completed in 1888, and it was the way for the railroad to cross the Willamette. It was the first crossing of the Willamette and tied together Portland with the rest of the West Coast and then later on the whole country. And that brought along with it that sort of beginning of growth of Portland as both a outpost in the Pacific Northwest, but also a regional city, linking together the Willamette Valley, the Inland Empire with wheat production, as well as timber production. So it really spurred Portland forward. It was the Union Pacific Railroad who actually built that first bridge. And they are still the owners today of the steel bridge. When the second steel bridge was built in 1912, and it changed from a pivoting bridge to now this very unique, unlike anything else in the world, bridge that could raise up from the river, still maintain pedestrian and electric trolley car traffic on the top, was a very unique and unlike anything else that had been conceived. This is the easiest point to cross, but this is also the hardest point to get everything to flow through that narrow connection point. And since the steel bridge was created to be a multimodal bridge, it's been able to deal with that pretty well. Even in 1912, when it was originally built and constructed, it was really anticipating that the rail portion, the lower portion of the bridge, was really going to handle that heavy load. The upper deck, yes, is going to have dynamic motion of cars and trucks eventually, but adding a light rail, which is not all that light, on top of the top deck of the steel bridge, that's always been a big challenge. And when we built the first line out to Gresham, we had to shut down the bridge for 2 years just to both bring it up to date, modernize it, and transform it so that it could handle light rail coming across the top deck. And when we finally made the decision 2008 to just say only light rail will occupy the two inner lanes, just so we wouldn't have cars going over the switches and all the mechanics of the rail system, putting only automobile traffic on the outside. It can handle a certain level of dynamic impacts, but repeated over time, that's that duration, which is also why we have to run our train so slowly across it. We're trying to minimize that pounding of the bridge and going over the switches, crossing over the bridge. And the project that we're going to be doing this summer, first time replacing all the track and the switches, it's a huge effort to do that, but it's leveraging something that we have grown to understand and appreciate in Portland. I think the steel bridge evokes the character and the personality of Portland. We're both gritty, we're tough, we're both dynamic movements. We're always looking for the next thing to make our lives, you know, that much more wonderful place to live here in Portland. At the end of the day, I still got to have a beautiful structure that functions. No matter how quirky it is, no matter how unique it is, I have to rely upon you, and you got to deliver for me every day.